Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to the next episode of Soloing the Ark and Scorched Earth. I'm Flinger Fu, and today, well, you know what? In between episodes, I have been doing a ton of work, and I'm actually kind of really digging it. See, this pagoda kind of thing, I like the platform, I do, but really, a platform's a platform, no matter how you dress it. But I think that I've found something that looks really good. I put these walls down around here and I moved the stairs so where it looks, I like the way it looks. And now I can actually, if I wanted to, I could encase this in, see, not that, get rid of that. All right, I could encase this all in greenhouse glass coming down like this. And I'm not done with the walls going all the way around. I'm about to finish up doing that. But yeah, I'm really digging that overhang that I've got going there. I think it's pretty cool looking. Let's see. Did I see a wyvern fly by earlier? No, that was one of mine. Okay. And then, yeah, I moved the stairs and it works out so much better. I mean, so much better. I have a lot more room with the stairs off to the side. Also, I began work on the next level, and then this right here is going to be the last functional platform, and then after this, it's all just going to be a roof, because I plan on having more pillars here, and then just a pagoda-style roof right up top. And I find that the adobe... Oh, no! Thanks, Ivy, you just saved me again. It's not the first time. Alright, so, yeah. I find that, the adobe, it looks great as, you know, the, kind of roof that you would find on certain pagodas. It's pretty cool. Alright, and, yeah, if you're not sure what a pagoda is, and the style I'm building, or at least trying for, look up a Japanese pagoda, because there's more, there's different types of pagodas. I'm not going for the Chinese or the Korean or anything like that, I'm going for more Japanese style. And I dig that, and, you know, it just seems kind of cool. Now, I'm not going to get them very, it's not going to be, you know, completely, but, you know, I'm trying. And I'm trying hard because, you know, I like the idea of this, and it gives me something to build and just be creative on. So, yeah. All right, so without further ado, oh, you know, I need Ivy. All right, Ivy, come on. All right, so now we have to get Ivy, and then we have to go down to this bottom platform because I have to finish putting in the walls on the lip going around. And this is how I have to do it. I have to get on a wyvern, reposition them in a hop off, and then, let's see. It's not the easiest thing in the world, but you know, I'm fine with that. If it was easy, it wouldn't be, you know, it wouldn't be worth it. All right, so hey. All right, so yeah, I'm gonna get putting this out. And I have to make sure on each one of these that I click the use button. Right? No, I went straight. No! Ah! No, I think I kind of like that better. Huh. No, but I went straight around, so now I have to... No. All right. Let's see if I can get... Don't move. Don't move, Ivy. There you go. Hey, nailed it. All right. And yeah, if you... when you're placing these things, use the wall... Or you have to use the button, click the use button, so where it rotates it. Oh. Okay. All right, well, I'm going to get finishing doing this and then bring you guys back, and then we're going to chat a little bit, because I have to chat some. Oh, no! All right, so I can just place that there, and then it'll... Okay. All right, and we're going to chat a little bit, and I will bring you guys back when I'm done with this, all right? So I'll see you guys in a bit. See you then. All right, so now I finished the bottom lip, so now I'm back up here working on the top, trying to get this out this? I stopped him. See, you know, if I was afraid of heights, this would be a really big pain in the butt. But fortunately, I'm not. So, hey. Alright, so, yeah, let's get this. And where are you? See, is this it? Yeah. Hey, Mr. Tapajar, how you doing? You know, I still never named you. Maybe one of these days I should. Right, and, yeah, I've been, grinding a whole ton off camera. But, yeah, there's a couple things I want to discuss. Because here pretty soon, there's gonna be some changes coming to Ark here soon. And they're interesting. They're not really changes to Scorched Earth, per se. Because, you know, they're gonna be adding some new dinos and stuff like that. But, they intend to put out the beta version of, and I realize the entire game is in beta, but they intend on bringing out the beta procedurally generated arcs, and that sounds like a ton of fun. And I actually have a feeling that it's not going to be coming out in this next patch. I mean, they say it is, but yeah, yeah. So, I've heard that before. But, yeah, I mean, if it is, awesome. I mean, amazing. I'm actually really, really looking forward to it. The procedurally generated arcs. But if it doesn't come out in this patch, I'm not going to be surprised and I'm not going to be upset. But if it does, then I think I might just take this save. Take this save and put it on, you know, put it in a folder, set it off to the side, and then see what I can do with the procedurally generated one. Because, I mean, I love doing that. But I think I'm going to put a timer on that. Maybe a 30-episode timer, just to see what stuff I can do in it. And also, there was a comment on the video yesterday that made a ton of sense. I mean, because I love doing the beginner's guide stuff. I really do. I had a ton of fun doing the center beginner's edition or beginner's guide because that's the way I love to play. I mean, I love to solo. Even way back, and I'm going to throw some, I'm going to be, you know, aging myself here for a minute. Way back when EverQuest first came out. Yeah, you heard that right, EverQuest. Everybody always said, you know, that you can't solo certain things. And I took that as a personal challenge, you know, and that's just the kind of gamer I am. So I took out, you know, a lowly shaman out, and I decided to solo every single thing I could. And I've always been like that. So I try to push how far and how extreme I can solo stuff. And I realized that, you know, in Ark, that once you reach a point, everything becomes soloable. And it's true. But you have to be able to get there. And I notice a lot of people have problems getting there. But, you know, when you're soloing all this stuff, you pick up all this knowledge that you're, you know, all these little tricks and stuff like that. And so doing a beginner's guide, it helps me share all the tricks that I find out along the way to everybody. And I really enjoy that aspect of doing the beginner's guide because it allows me to go, hey, you know what? When I was trying to figure out this, I racked my brain for a little bit, and, you know, it didn't come to me, and then finally, I figured it out, and here's the end result, guys. I mean, this is one of the easiest ways of doing it, and that's what I love doing with the beginner's guides, because, you know, it's like in the center, when I was figuring out the easiest way to set up a kibble farm, I mean, I made it look easy, and that's one of the best things, is when you, when you take something that's difficult or it takes time and you make it look easy, it's one of the best feelings when you can show somebody else how to do it so where it looks easy and make them do it so where it everything just goes smoothly. I love doing that. I love helping people. I love interacting with people. I love soloing, but soloing and interacting with people, they're not real good bedfellows, so, you know, yeah. But when it comes down to art, I love solo. I mean, I love playing multiplayer too. Don't get me wrong. I love multiplayer. But it's just one of those things that I love the soloing the arc kind of gameplay. But I'm thinking about, and I got really sidetracked there before I went off on that tangent. I'm thinking about starting up. That's not going to cut it. Only 17 ceilings? I'm going to need to do more of that. All right, so I'm thinking about when they do the procedurally generated stuff, either doing that or doing a beginner's guide for Scorched Earth. Because I like doing those beginner's guide things. And also, I love the idea of the map being completely random. I mean, that right there, the idea of an Ark map being completely random, because I love this game. I love Ark. There's only a few games that I can say I love as much as this game. I mean, Game Dev Tycoon, let's see, Vanilla WoW, stuff like that. Yeah, there's only a few games that I really love as much as Ark that I can just do so much stuff like this in. I mean, like KOTOR and stuff like that. I love those games. But Ark, it's just amazing. And then the fact that you could do it so where every single game of Ark is new and fresh with procedurally generated map. Oh my god, mind blown, all right? If you could see it, it's just smoke coming out my ears right before my temples implode. All right, so yeah. And just the idea of that is just... It's just amazing. So, yeah. I'm thinking that... I don't know. I'm finishing the pagoda regardless. Because I have to do that. I mean, I started it. I have to finish it. I love doing this. This is just a ton of fun. And it gives me just something just amazing that I can do. And I'm loving that. And I need more ceilings. What am I lacking on ceilings? I'm lacking wood. Okay, I had more wood back down there. Because I need to do the outer rung around. And which is the pillar that I started... That I first... Okay, I need to bring down the other four pillars now. And then I need to run the outer ceiling around the outside. Okay. So, yeah. Alright. Well, hey, I will bring you guys back. And I'm going to go craft up a ton more ceilings. I have a feeling I'm going to have to take out grayscale and go grab a bunch more wood. And then also, I know I have a whole ton of clay already made. I'm probably going to have to make more. I know I'm going to have to make more. But all right, yeah, let me do the outer rung, and I'll bring you guys back when I'm doing that, all right? So I'll see you guys in a bit. See you then. All right, and we're back. So yeah, I have a whole ton of... Yeah, let's put that there. A whole ton of slope ceilings that I'm putting on here on the edge. And it's a lot easier the second time around after I have the experience of doing the one down below. Yeah, it's a lot easier. I need to put the ramps or the rails right like that. But yeah, I mean, I'm digging it. I'm really digging it. Let's go take a look, see how it looks. And I'm not going to put the lip like I did on the bottom one. Here, let me show you. Right along here with the wall lip. So where I actually have enough room to fly the wyverns in. Okay. See, so where I actually have enough room to fly the wyverns in. So, yeah. And then the next platform area that I think I'm going to do... Oh, hey! All right, well, hey, I need to take off anyway. Yeah, I'm digging it. So the next one I'm going to do is going to be slightly shorter. But... And then I'm going to start slowly capping it off. Because I'm going to do a... The cap isn't going to be one solid thing. It's going to be multi-tiered. And it's basically just going to be for looks. Yeah. And because if you're doing a pagoda, you need to do a pagoda. You know, it needs to be slightly in on each one. And then it needs to go up to a point. Right? Okay, so yeah, that's what we're going to do. It's going to take a lot of resources. And that's right there is probably going to take the most amount of resources. Out of all of them, is capping it off and doing it so where it's aesthetically pleasing. So this way here, I have places to store all of my, wyverns. Plus, I can also how something that I think looks kind of cool. So, yeah, and I don't think I'm going to line this inner lining right here with walls. I mean, because from the outside, you really don't even see it. But, you know, I'll know it's there, but, you know, it's, yeah. Yeah. I like this part, though. I like this. This took me a while to get that. Yeah. All right, so, yeah, back to the grind, and I will bring you guys back when I have the next layer up, and I'm starting to build the roof, all right? So I will see you guys then. See you then. All right, and we're back, and I'm just starting to put this touches up on here, and then from here, I think I'm going to, I'm not sure how, but I think I'm going to go with an extra set of pillars right here in the middle, and then from there, I'm going to bring another, let's see, I'm going to go with an extra set of pillars right up here, and then I'm going to bring the ceiling in a little bit farther so where I can go up, and then from there, and then bring it in so where eventually I can go to a tapered spot. I'm hoping I can do that. I don't know. if I would have went with a bottom ceiling, I probably could have done that a lot easier, but, you know, there we go. Okay. Then I have to just go here. And then, let's see, 8. There we go. Okay. And I have to get back. And I will die if I fall from here. So, yeah. Let's see. Happening in the right spot. There we go. All right, that's where I wanted. Drop down there. All right, so, no. There. 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 Now I have to figure out a way to get back to my Tapajara, which I don't think is going to happen. So. All right, come here, dude. Come on. Oh, no, come. Really? There we go. Thank you. All right, so I'm going to get this finished. And yeah, from here, I think I'm going to bring it in a little bit and then bring it in a little bit more and then bring it in a little bit more. But I'm going to have one layer of pillars in between each one. So where each one is slightly elevated from the other one. Yeah, that's going to be a pain in the butt. But you know what? I want to get that done. It sounds really cool, actually. All right, so, yeah. Come on, just land, dude. Land! No, that's where you want to land. Land! Yeah, come on. Come on. The Tapajara doesn't want to land. All right. No. No. All right, so I'll bring you guys back in just a little bit. See you. All right, so how's it look so far? And I think, I'm taking a look back from here and seeing how it looks. But I brought up a pillar, put out some ceilings, brought up another pillar, put out some more ceilings, brought up another pillar. And those are going to be going all the way around with sloped ceilings or sloped roofs. So it basically comes to a point, but it's going to be an extended point. You know what I mean? So, yeah. And I'm really kind of digging it. The only part I'm having a problem with is how this is just so open. But then again, I realize, and I have to keep telling myself, that it has to be open or else it's going to be pointless because I need to be able to park my Wyverns in there because I still have Wyverns over at that base I haven't been able to bring over here because I just don't want to park them around the outside. Plus, also, as I get more Wyverns, I can just keep adding to it and eventually I can just have row upon row upon row upon row of Wyverns. It's kind of cool. All right, and let's go over. Let's take a look. I am coming back from another haul of sand. Here, look at this. Every single time. It's just that much. Yeah, grinder is amazing for getting clay. Absolutely amazing. All right, let's run in here. And we'll go up and I'll take a look at it with the Tapajara. He's off. He buggered off somewhere. He let me fall, and then he just took off. I think he was like, you know what? You just fell. You almost died. Broke your leg. I'm out of here, man. Yeah. Yeah, it's happened a few times. So, yeah. Man, I've been falling a lot. Yeah. I've been falling a lot. I think I've been going through most of my food just because I've been falling so much. But yeah, if you guys don't have a grinder mantis yet, I can't recommend them enough. I mean, they're just so amazing. I mean, this guy right here, just whatever you need, just run out and get. All right, let's see if we can go find the tapajara. He's somewhere around here. He took off. Oh, there he is. All right. All right. Alright, so now this is what I have planned. Is as it goes out like this, and each one of these is going to have a row of slope ceilings all the way around. All the way around. And then, so it's going, I think I need to go with one more layer, but I'm going to finish these up and see exactly how it looks then. And then I might just do a solid row right down the center. Kind of like, we're pretty high up. I didn't realize we're that high up. The one down there on the side, on the left, the one that I did, I think I might just do one solid row of that down the middle, you know, so where it's just a straight ceiling with two slope down the side. Look kind of cool, all right? And I'm really, really digging it. So, yeah. Yeah, all right. So I have more to get done, and I will bring you guys back because I am determined that I am going to finish this, right? I'm just determined. I have to finish. Hey gosh, at least in this episode. I was thinking it might go on to a third episode, but I think I'm just going to cut the camera, get a whole ton done, bring you guys back, and then we'll cap this sucker off, all right? So I'll see you guys in a bit. See you then. All right, so I have some really weird infrastructure here, but I think... I mean, I had to do, like, here, let me show you. Let me get something with... Oh, there we go. All right, I had to get pillars going up this way, and then ceilings coming out that way, and then pillars, and then ceilings, and then pillars. And then it went all the way up like this. And then over here, I had to go straight out like this. So the center infrastructure is super weird. And then I got this lip right there that I just couldn't get rid of. I busted this down like four different times and redid it, and the only way to do it would be to extend the ceiling over to this side and then build another one down that. And I think I might actually do that. I was trying to be stubborn and avoid that. And this right here, can you? I have to be very careful what I break. Yeah, this one right here can just go. Alright, watch the whole ceiling just go BAM! Right? Oh man, that would not be the first time. Okay. So, yeah, let me see. Let me get my spyglass. And then, you know, I'll just put the bow back down there because I think I'm done building for now. I mean, I could be touching this thing up a lot, but come on, dude. Oh, I missed you. You were going just too fast, man. Come on, dude. Back here. Come on. All right, fine. You know what? It's going to be the first time I've done this. Geronimo! All right. Now, come on, dude. Get over here. All right. Oh, come on. There you go. All right. So, let's get out here and let's take a look because I kind of like the way it looks. I mean, what do you think? I like the way the roof is. I mean, it's just a multi-tiered platform, but I'm kind of digging it. I need to get rid of the ladder, but it'll give me a huge area to park all my wyverns, and I did the roof like that in a particular way because I wanted to have it. I don't know. I like that. I find that very appealing. I could doctor it up a little bit so where it's more uniform, but you know what? I don't think I need to. I mean, it's all there. And yeah. So, hey. Yeah, let's take a look down here. Get on top of Foo Central. Yeah. It's not bad. All right, it's huge. All right, and we got a place for all our wyverns. I'm gonna have to go get all the other wyverns over the other base. But I think that's gonna do it for this episode. All right, hey, if you like the episode, click like. I appreciate that. And until tomorrow, this is Flinger Foo, and take it easy, everyone.